Welcome to another special edition of Government House Daily, a program that brings you the activities of His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Kano State, Engineer Raju Musa Fonkoso, from within and outside the state. My name is Wani Mahmoud Selba, your guide for today's saying thank you for joining us. Raju Musa Fonkoso reiterated commitment to the development of science and technology for the socio-economic growth of the state. Governor Fonkoso was speaking when he paid a visit to the Minister of Science and Technology, Professor Ekon Basi Ewa, in Abuja.
Well, just to say once again, congratulations for this well-deserved appointment. Let me also take the opportunity to congratulate my sister also for the well-deserved appointment. I always remember when I was governor in 1993, when she was handling a very important assignment. We were always together in Kano. Minister, I want to also thank you for create time to see us. And also say that Kano State has also gone to Ministry of Science and Technology. And being a product of science and technology myself, together with you, we should support and assist this ministry to achieve its desired goals. Since we are sworn in on the 29th of May this year, we have worked so hard, not only through this ministry, but all other ministries and infrastructures, course agencies, and we have achieved so much in the last few months. The Minister, I'm happy to tell you that through this ministry, we have been working to ensure that the ministry has achieved the desired goals. But in terms of the new ministry, with certain goals, we need to come and compare notes with you and through you, all the directors, all the agencies that are under this ministry. Science and technology, as you all know, in the future. And it is our collective responsibility to build the future for ourselves, children and grandchildren. Right now, the ministry has under it an ICT partner. And we want to strengthen ICT, Kano. That's why our administration, last few months, decided to establish 18 institutions. One of the institutions, these 18 institutions, is the Kano Informatics. This institution has already taken off with 204 students, and they are now in their temporary site, and of course, we are working on the permanent site in Kura local governments, and that is what they hold their power in science.
The Minister of Science and Technology, Professor Ewa, commended the effort of Kano State Government and pledged the support of his ministry in ensuring the success of Kano Science and Technology Development Programs.
Our ministry is trying to partner with you to provide all this support to ensure that park makes the desirable impact in the state and the country as well. Also, collaboration between Kano State Government and a number of our agencies here, such as Ms. Tim, which is collaborating with the state in terms of capacity building and the design of the STI policy. That was true that Kano State was stated in the draft of this policy, which is yet to be implemented and still being considered by the Federal Executive Council. The answer is also the raw materials research development council, which is also ready to assist your state. And more interesting, the NASA Space Agency will establish an advanced laboratory for space technology applications at BUK. NASA is also willing to assist in intellectual property. Assume that as your SMEs, as your agencies involved with indigenous technology, it is worthwhile necessary to keep the intellectual property well preserved, and therefore the patenting of some of your technology, establishment of more agencies as frankly said, and then the digital server of them, which are highly relevant for the SMT policies. The Kano University of Technology is also a big deal for us because we are sure that most of the people and industries of Kano State have an opportunity to be exposed. It also has told us that you've been feeding most of your students and your pupils. We have an agency called FUE that will partner with you to actually assist in micronutrient issues.
Similarly, Governor Kwankwaso was at the Federal Ministry of Information, Communication Technology, where he met the Minister Omobola Johnson and discussed on how to enhance Kano ICT Park.
I'm sure you are aware that Kano has got an ICT Park. We also have created one of our first time University of Science and Technology. And recently, this year, our administration also established Kano Ecolabs. Among this institution, we have other 17 institutions that are at various levels of development. We have Kano Team Institute, we have Kano Livestock Institute, Kano Poultry Institute, we have Kano Fisheries Institute, we have Kano Informatics Research, and we have Kano Corporate Security Institute, we have Kano Entrepreneurial Development Institute, we also have Kano Port Cancer and various institutions of that being activities. In all these institutions have got relationship with people. And we feel that we should come to this ministry to see how we can work together with news and NCC and other institutions that do that. Thank you. We thank all the staff of the ministry and the consultants that are here, and also to
control the power of the leadership. We were very much looking forward to work together with this ministry for the purpose of our government to panel and indeed the purpose of the federal government. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, for giving us to come and hear such before today. As you know, we're a new ministry, and it's not often that we get that responsibility, but we're still trying to establish ourselves. So very, thank you very much for thinking of that. We will work with you to ensure that that IT can deliver what we can do to create opportunities for businesses and entrepreneurs the need to have better capacity for training and teaching in the area of ICT. One of the requests in the discussion that we had was how do we begin to build capacity within colleges and the teaching and the ability of teachers to teach children how to do and how to help them with teaching. The other thing we talked about was again the actual having to teach in schools in colleges. The government information commended the effort of NCC and all the students in the donation of the decisions that Roy does in some of the schools and some of the schools. I assure him that it's something that we're going to continue. We're looking at different ways of doing this acceleration. But the whole idea of getting Nigerians comfortable with ICT, getting Nigerians, or moving Nigerians to visit the company or ICT, is key on the agenda. The only way we can do that is to build capacity and build skills of individuals and drivers. I have promised to come to the panel in the very near future to first go and see the IT part, where we are with it, and begin to work in developing ideas on how we can actually get that to the technology integration center and move very quickly into implementation, having publicly having invested quite a lot in the infrastructure. So once again, thank you very much for coming. I apologize that we have no power. I have no communication. We don't need the government. We don't need the exercise. But thank you very much.
On the 24th of November 2011, Governor Raibu Musa Okonkwo says his administration will embark on laying pipes from Chanawa water treatment plants to Goren Duze Reservoir in Kano City. Governor Okonkwo disclosed these during an interactive session with officials of the State Ministry of Water Resources, State Water Board Management Officers at the Government House.
Bayan wannan akwai manyan
that are getting in the work. Some of them are getting in the work. And they have told that they are also in some sort of a business. It's a whole business where they have been there. One and two, a lot of people do the world, so one and five. And one and three. I think that he didn't really matter. I think that the people who are in the world.
You said the contract of the pipe will cost billions of naira, adding that the project will alleviate the shortage of water in the northern part of the state. Governor Kwankwaso, however, said state government will provide fuel to all water works in the state with a view to making them functional. A 16-member technical committee has been inaugurated to design a blueprint for the establishment of Second Kano State University. Professor Lawan Bichi is the chairman, and Abdullah Gizar will serve as secretary of the committee.
We decided to establish our first university, first state-owned university here in Kano. We had a committee that advised the government. And coincidentally, the committee was under the chairmanship of Dr. Umar Garba Dambata, who is now a professor. They have done a fantastic job, and I'm happy to say that the report we received gave us all the encouragement and direction we required, and that was why we are able to establish that university. We are all aware also that when we left in 2003 to 2011, when we came back, the university faced numerous problems, and I'm happy that it survived the 8 years. And when we came, I'm happy also to say that it's one of the few places that I visited within the first weeks of our administration, this second administration. They had so many problems. Of course, we regard Kano University of Science and Technology as our baby. And for that reason, we gave them all the support they require. In fact, just yesterday, we approved some money for the completion of the abandoned hostel and library in Udil. And also, the state government is very willing to give the university all the support, all the resources they require, of course, within the limit of our own resources. We have studied the situation, the tertiary institution, the students from this state who require admission into tertiary institutions. we realize that there is huge need for additional university in Kano State, especially that the Wudul is a specialized university catering for sciences and of course technology, and there are many other people, students, who require other areas. That's why the state government has decided to establish a conventional university to be sited here in the city of Kano.
Kano State government has launched a modern data collection system that will ascertain the number of unemployed youths in the state.
Nawa ne da suka gama jami'a ba su da aiki? Guda nawa ne suka gama secondary? Guda nawa ne suka gama primary? Kuma guda nawa ne ma ba su yi bokon ba kuma suke da buƙatar taimako ko goyon baya domin su samu makaranta ko aikin yi? A jihar Kano yau din nan mun yi rijista ta marasa wanda suka gama jami'a ba su da aikin yi har zuwa yanzu mun yi rijistar 6,712. Waɗanda suka gama secondary ba su ci gaba ba kuma ba su aikin yi a yanzu muna da 49,331. Da kuma wanda suka gama secondary ba su ci gaba ba ko ba su da aikin yi wanda suka gama primary mun yi rijista ta 33,909. Sai kuma waɗanda ba su yi karatu ba su kuma mutum 16,867. Su ne waɗanda muka yi wa rijista. Ma'anar wannan shi ne mu san mutum nawa ne yanzu ba shi da aikin yi. Wannan ya sa ma muka gaya wa makarantar ilimi mai zurfi Higher Education da su yi rijista ta duk mutumin da yake da diploma ko yake da digiri. Yanzu suna nan suna rijista, ya kamata wanda bai bai je. A cikinsu muna sa rai za mu samu wasu, muna duba 'yan kudaden da suke aljihunmu na gwamnati. Wataƙila mu ɗauki mutum aƙalla 100 abinda in sama mu fitar da su ƙasar waje mu je a koya musu aƙalla su yi digiri na fari su dawo gida. In suka dawo jami'o'in nan da manyan makarantu da muke buɗewa mu tura su je su koyar ko mu saba musu wani aiki. Banda wannan yanzu kun gani na je ni ma na yi rijista. Muna son kowa ya shiga ya rijista, yanzu zamani ya zo. In baka iya harkar computer din nan ba ma zaka je ka nema ka iya.
Governor Konkoso, who launched the program, said the registration of the scheme will be online through Scratchcard to enable government easy access to the unemployed youth. Secretary to the State Government, Raju Suleiman Bichi, commended the effort of Governor Konkoso for empowering youth in the state. And that's all we have for you on the program Government House Daily. Until next week, Monday, inshallah, where we bring you another edition. My name is Uwani Muhammad Talba. Thank you for watching.